guys.
When you've gone through what Brad Kramer has gone through, every small moment means everything.
We haven't had s'mores in a couple weeks.
Never in the light.
Never in the light.
But Brad's life turned upside down after he noticed an unusual spot on his left leg.
There was two spots. There was one spot there and one spot there. So one was like the size of a quarter and the other.
And they were growing fast.
For weeks, he didn't think much of it. But when he got it checked out, he got the worst kind of news.
Oh, I was devastated. I mean, I don't think I really knew enough about melanoma to really understand how serious it was.
And Brad's skin cancer was spreading. Immunotherapy did work for a while until it suddenly didn't.
My cancer was so aggressive that they told me if my body did not respond to the medicine, that I would have had 6 to 9 months to live.
I was watching you every day get weaker. And it was scary.
Yeah.
But look at him. He doesn't seem sick, does he? Doesn't feel it either. Today, Brad is a living, breathing beacon of hope. He's currently part of a phase one clinical trial for a cancer vaccine, and the technology behind it is strikingly similar to something we've heard a lot about.
After months of research and clinical trials, the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine delivery underway.
Biotech company Moderna, as well as Pfizer and BioNTech, have been working on what's called an mRNA delivery approach to a vaccine.
It's at the University of Pennsylvania, work on messenger RNA laid the foundation for the most promising COVID vaccines we're seeing roll out around the world today. Drew Weissman is part of a team of biochemist pioneers who led that work. He's even got patents on it.
The main thing is that RNA is really a plug-and-play technology. So you can make any vaccine you want or any therapeutic protein you want with the exact same procedure.
Here's how an mRNA vaccine works. It gives the body a set of genetic instructions to make specific proteins. In the case of a COVID vaccine, it's teaching the body to make spike proteins, identical to the ones the coronavirus uses to break into our cells. On their own, they're harmless, but the body learns to identify them, so when the coronavirus comes knocking, it knows how to attack.
We're also working on cancer vaccines. They, of course, are trickier because cancer cells are our own. So it's very tricky to make a good cancer vaccine.
But they're trying, and in Brad's case, he was willing to give it a shot. The cancer had spread to his back. His bones were literally breaking. So he showed up to hospital once a week for an infusion of this experimental vaccine.
The reaction was always, it was always the same thing. My temperature would go up, and I would literally start shaking. And I would tell you within 5 to 10 minutes, I was back to complete normal. And the temperature would come down.
And so you were mentioning those spots, the quarter and nickel sized spots on your leg. What do those spots look like today?
They're gone. They don't exist.
Now, Brad is taking other cancer medication with the mRNA vaccine. So the science isn't certain which part of his treatment is doing most of the work or how long the results will last. But the speed of his recovery, astonishing. And stop for a moment to consider what else might be possible.
I think the development of that infrastructure will open up a vast array of possibilities.
Matthew Miller is a biochemist at McMaster University. He says, think beyond conventional vaccines, the way they're made, also what they could treat.
Infectious diseases like HIV or potentially a universal flu vaccine that could protect us against all flus, things like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's, for example, are other examples where mRNA vaccines may have utility.
It sounds like you're saying mRNA is kind of like the skeleton key that could potentially unlock every disease. I mean, is that right?
Yes, and I think it's certainly true that mRNA vaccines are likely to revolutionize our ability to vaccinate against a lot of different diseases.
To 2021.
Cheers. The mRNA revolution, a new beginning for Brad.
I am in remission and that there are no measurable cancer cells left in my body.
That sounds unbelievable.
I can't tell you how great it felt to hear that news.
To be clear, he still isn't home free, but he's home. And for now, that's more than good enough.